We want out! We want out! We want out! We want out!
And you mean to tell me that little fence you got up there is gonna keep that stuff over from under my house? I also live in the area where there's more heart trouble than any other place in this city. I'll show you right now, I had open heart surgery.
You're not human, you have no heart! How many people would not do this to people? You can't ruin our lives like this! You're destroying us! We're not people to you, we're numbers! Well, it's gotta stop!
Eight-month-old pregnant woman here. We lived in that house, we lived there for 2 years, we bought that house, nobody told us this was happening, man, nothing. She's been there for 8 months. What are you gonna do for my kids? What are you gonna do? Nothing.
Where they gonna go?
The damage is done, man, the damage is done.
Good evening, everybody. I'm John Beard.
And I'm Marie Rice. The frustration and helplessness of 2 years of living a nightmare for over 700 Love Canal families erupted Tuesday night. An overflow crowd packed the Niagara County Legislative Chambers in hopes of persuading their elected officials to join the proposed Love Canal Revitalization Authority. The proposal had been rejected before, and emotion filled the air as residents pleaded with the legislators before the vote.
I carried a child for 9 months. Our little Julie was stillborn. The loss of our child may be a direct result to the chemicals. Please don't allow this to happen to anyone else before you get them out. Don't let it happen to yourselves.
The proposal was turned down by a 16-15 vote, and once again, the Love Canal residents had their cause rejected. But this was one rejection too many. The people were mad, and they wanted answers.
Our county representatives who are supposed to support us, well, the nation's looking at you, you look like damn fools and murderers. And ultimately, in the end, you are gonna pay, because those who do wrong pay, sweetie. May you hate one of you are gonna pay.
I don't have any diseases.
How could you? I don't understand that.
I got mercy on you. I sure the hell don't.
After what you heard this past weekend, you've got the nerve to sit there and vote no?
Residents once again rallied around Love Canal Homeowners President Lois Gibbs. The legislators were jeered and shouted at, and finally sheriff's deputies were ordered to escort Mrs. Gibbs outside.
Legislators, please tell us why. I am not moving until I get an answer why.
Lois, would you grab the purse, please?
Please take the purse. All I know is why. I am not. All I want is
the residents decided they had done all they could and went home to prepare for Wednesday's announcement from Washington. That announcement from President Carter was the triumph residents had fought 2 long years for.
President Carter today declared an emergency to permit the federal government and the state of New York to undertake the temporary relocation of approximately 700 families in the Love Canal area of Niagara Falls.
The good news was also mixed with feelings of uncertainty and sadness as residents wondered where they would go and if they would ever see any of their friends and neighbors again. Love Canal residents will be relocated, but the scars will never disappear. We'll take a look back at the last 2 years when Love Canal Neighborhood in Fear continues.
Someday, it will happen. Slowly, insidiously, without your knowing it, until it's too late.
Everything's ruined.
Not anymore. Now there's the water alarm. As soon as even a trickle of water touches its contacts, you'll know. It's battery operated. Just set it anywhere you may have a water problem and relax. The Water Alarm from Northern.
Now available at brand names, Century House, and Twin Fair stores.
Olsen Swimming Hole. Well, you go north about two... No, you don't. You go south about 2 miles down. You can't get there from here.
How about cooling off with Country Time instead?
Country Time lemonade flavored drink.
Oh, great lemon flavor.
Not too tart, not too sweet. Tastes like good old-fashioned lemonade.
Why?
Country Time. Country Time, tastes like that good old-fashioned lemonade.
Introducing a motor oil for the 80s. New SF quality Uniflow from Exxon. It works here, under the tremendous heat and pressure of today's engine. New Uniflow protects so well, it actually exceeds the newest and toughest standard of the American Petroleum Institute. And it was proven in tests to stretch an average of 15 extra miles from a tank of gas. Change to new Uniflow and join the drive for better mileage.
Joe, you made fresh bread coffee. You didn't.
I didn't.
You didn't?
It's Maxim.
Dad, you didn't.
I didn't. It's Maxim.
Maxim freeze-dried coffee has a rich ground aroma and rich taste. So close to fresh perked, they'll think you did when you didn't.
Happy birthday.
Oh, honey. Fresh per coffee? You didn't.
He didn't.
It's Maxim.
The tragedy of the Love Canal has been a two-year-long story. Let's go back to the summer of 1978. The Love Canal, the most infamous chemical dump in the nation. A distinction earned because the eyes of the country have been riveted on that small patch of land in Niagara Falls since 239 families were moved at state expense 2 years ago. Finally declared a federal emergency, it's the only hazardous waste site to be identified as such. The dream of William Love turned nightmare. In 1894, the entrepreneur had a scheme for a giant model city and water canal to provide industrial power. The plan was aborted. Cooper Chemicals then used the dead canal as a dumping ground for industrial waste. From above, it looked harmless enough, but only a few feet below the surface, deadly chemicals were gurgling their way to the top, finding their way into the basements of nearby residents. The prognosis was grim: birth defects, kidney ailments, respiratory problems, possibly even death, accompanied the path of the migrating toxins. August 2nd, 1978, State Health Commissioner Dr. Robert Whalen declared a state of emergency at the Love Canal and advised pregnant women and children under 2 years old to be evacuated immediately.
Well, how dangerous is it for a person just standing there right now?
You have to take into consideration three or four variables. The first variable are the levels of air pollution in the individual homes. Two, you have to take into consideration the relative risk for a particular individual. Children and unborn children being the highest risk. Three, you have to take into consideration the duration of the risk. And these are the issues that we tried to balance out among our own scientific staff and with a nationwide expert panel and arrived at the conclusions that resulted in my order.
Well, what is the ultimate status of this area going to be? Is it going to be leveled, do you think, ultimately?
I think that what we're trying to do here is deal with first things first. The concerns of the people who have to leave, I think, is our first concern. The question of trying to do something to reduce the immediate problems, the construction, is the second one. The task force set up by Governor Kerry will continue to meet, and we'll try to meet and determine other more long-range suggestions and proposals as time goes on.
Would you please tell me? Do I not?
He has ordered that families with children under the age of two should be evacuated. I think that's a double standard, and I don't believe that that's fair to anybody. I think any family that fears for their lives and that of their family should be given the same opportunity to be moved into quarters that gives their family protection while the work continues of cleaning up this mess.
The White House insisted that a return for their backing, the state agreed, and I think you will be glad at this, that the state pursue the polluters to make sure.
Thing we wanted most was security in our home, and we don't have it. So I, at Dr. Whalen's suggestion, I picked up my wife and my two sons, and I took them away from here to what presumably is safety, I hope.
August 5th, 1978, William Wilcox, administrator for the U.S. Federal Disaster Aid Administration, arrives from Washington to tour the contaminated area.
Why are they making us stay? And it's not in the paper anything about the remedial work. They want the funds for the remedial work, but they're forgetting about the people. We've suffered enough medically. Do we have to die while they're cleaning it up? Now please take that back to Washington.
I
will. Wilcox was ordered here by the White House. He was to report directly to the president on how bad the situation really was. He was personally escorted across the decades-old chemical landfill. The federal official, wearing only shoes, says he brings boots when he visits flood sites, but didn't know he would need them here today. A hole where waste had risen to the surface was pointed out. He went inside the residents' homes to see and smell more waste that had entered through basements. Wilcox said he was most anxious to hear from the residents. None was bashful.
Everything started dying out here.
Let me ask you this question. I should have asked it of some of the others, maybe you too. If you were to leave this area for some period of time, 6 months or something, and the houses were boarded up, and then this was all cleaned up, and you got assurances that there wasn't a problem, would you come back?
No. That's not what we're looking for.
What are you looking for?
We're looking for to be moved out of the area permanently. I don't care. 10 years from now, if they clean that back up, clean our property up, we're still no value to our homes, but the reputation is still here.
Mm-hmm.
Many people...
Mr. Wilcox, what's your impression of what you've seen so far this morning?
Well, I think both in scientific terms and in human terms, it's a very troublesome situation. That's really about all I can say at the present time. I think that people are living here under very difficult circumstances. We'll be preparing a report, pulling together all the information, providing a report to the White House tomorrow.
What chance do you think there is that these people might get federal aid?
Well, I think that there's going to be federal assistance in one form or another. The only question is what is the best form of assistance, and we'll want to be working closely with Governor Kerry and Mr. Hardy of his staff and others in formulating any federal program that seems appropriate for the situation.
August 10th, 1978, the state of New York makes history. It announces it will permanently relocate 239 families. Left behind, however, are more than 700 families. For some, then, there's jubilation. For others, despair. Still others clung to the belief that eventually they'd be moved.
It stinks at nighttime real bad. And did you see all the oils and stuff that are coming up? It's real sickening. And, you know, when I wake up in the morning, I have asthma real bad, and I can't breathe, and my eyes are all swollen. And, you know, when I wake up in the morning and stuff like that.
Are you worried about your baby?
Yes, because I don't want a deformed baby or something wrong with it or something like that, you know?
February 8, 1979, another unsettling announcement from the New York State Health Department. New Health Commissioner David Axelrod recommends the temporary relocation of all pregnant women and children under two who lived within a six-block area of the contaminated landfill.
When we examined all of the data and compared the effects, which I've already enumerated, on the wet areas with the dry areas, we found that there was indeed an increase in risk for the fetus. That is, that there was a small but significant risk, higher than would be anticipated, for those living in the wet areas. And these risks were manifested by increases of approximately twofold in congenital malformations, in spontaneous abortions, and in an increase in low birth weight infants. The decision, recommendation that the panel made to the New York State Department of Health at a meeting held yesterday was that based on this information, we should recommend that the fetus, in effect, be removed from the source of exposure. That defines itself as meaning that pregnant women living in the so-called wet areas should be removed from the canal areas.
It was a health hazard in August to children 2 and under. People from 99th and 97th had children that were a few months over 2 years old. They were advised to leave because of the health of their children. My daughter was under 2 then. She's 2 years and 4 months now. Why is she of no importance now?
I was in as much danger in August with my baby as I am now. Why was I forced to stay here all this time? I'm going to have my baby soon.
Ma'am, in August when the order was issued previously... I'm sorry. I'll be glad to come back.
Almost two. She'll be almost two, but she was a year and a half when this all started. And a 2 and a half when it all started. Now she's 3. You don't think I'm as concerned about my 3-year-old as I am of this baby I'm carrying?
I'm sorry. Can he answer the question, please, ma'am? What I said was that the age of 2 represented a reasonable assertion as to a point when the maximum impact from these chemicals would be diminished.
This was the first time the health department had given serious consideration to research gathered by the Homeowners Association. The women told us the state office had dismissed their studies connecting the pathways of old stream beds and increased health problems as useless housewife data.
I'm not a scientist. I am a housewife, as I've seen quoted in the paper many times. My data is not useless, it is not pointless, and it's not invalid. Every one of these people in this audience plus gave me that data. They don't lie. What you're doing in the health department is going to take 6 months, 8 months, 10 months. You prove that pregnant women are in danger. You prove that children under 2 are in danger. I know from my own family experience that there are other children in this area that are not even in danger, but are damn right out dying. And if we sit and wait for 6 more months for the Blue Ribbon Panel, with Lord only knows who they are, meet and decide on this, we're going to have dead children.
October 26, 1979, New York announced agreement on legislation to remove an additional 550 families. The details of that plan have yet to be carried out. December 20, 1979, the company says the property was deeded to the City Board of Education in 1953 for $1, and the school system was warned about the site. Hooker says it was contractually agreed that the board could make no claim against Hooker when it took possession. May 16, 1980, rare chromosomal damage is found in a sampling of Love Canal residents.
We found 2 particular characteristics in this study which are ominous. One, that there were more ring chromosomes than one would expect to find. But secondly, and more disturbing, was the presence of what we call extra fragments. And that is a very rare observation in any population.
Well, we have got abnormalities in our chromosomes, and we've known it all along that on our street alone there has been already 8 cases of cancer on a 15-house street. And it's really had me scared all along, but they tell me it was a national average. And now I have found proof that probably I will even get it again.
May 19, 1980. 2 EPA officials are held hostage for 6 hours.
Frank, do you have any comment for us?
No, no comment. I'll have a statement later on in the night.
If we do not have a disaster declaration Wednesday by noon, then what they have seen here today is just a Sesame Street picnic in comparison to what we will do.
When did Toro revolutionize the hose and reel? When Toro designed a hose and reel system so 50 feet weighs less than 4 pounds. When water can even flow through kinks because of a flexible yet tough construction. When it reels in flat and dry for compact storage in boats, cars, and campers. An incredibly versatile hose and reel system that's good enough to be a Toro.
Available at Century House.
Hold it. If my blue bonnet isn't the lightest tasting margarine you've ever tried, I'll eat my bonnet.
Delicious.
Wait. If my blue bonnet isn't the lightest tasting margarine that you've ever had, I'll eat my bonnet.
This is good.
I've made my blue bonnet margarine with a delicate light taste, one that really brings out the good flavor of food. And if this isn't the lightest tasting margarine you've ever tried, I'll eat my bonnet.
The dog you love only gets one meal a day, and if it's dull, he's out of luck. So don't just water his dry food down. Gravy, gravy, gravy it up.
When you stir up Gravy Train, you unlock a rich gravy coating for a nutritious meal he really loves. So don't just water it down.
Gravy, gravy, gravy it up. Gravy, gravy, gravy it up.
Angela, I just sold the Scott Mansion.
Terrific. This calls for coffee.
Whoa.
Only half a cup. Don't you like my coffee?
Mmm. Love the rich taste. It's the caffeine I can do without.
You happen to be drinking Brim decaffeinated coffee.
This is Brim?
This is Brim. And it's decaffeinated, so you don't have to stop at half a cup.
If it tastes this rich, I don't want to stop. Fill it to the rim.
With Brim?
Fill your cup to the rim with the rich taste of Brim.
Homeowners President Lois Gibbs has fought for relocation long and hard over the last 2 years. She's with us tonight. Mrs. Gibbs, 700 families can now be relocated. How far away from the canal do they live?
Well, they live on this map. You can see Buffalo Avenue to the south, Burkholz Creek to the north, 93rd Street on the west, and 103rd on the east side.
And how wide of a block area is that exactly?
That's a 10-block area.
And Mrs. Gibbs, you said the federal government said it would take them from 6 to 9 months to buy up the homes of the Love Canal residents. Now, in the last 2 years, you've gotten some pretty good sources of your own in Washington. How long do you think it may take?
I think it's just a matter of days. I don't think it's going to take 120 or 160 days that they're quoting. You're dealing with EPA officials and health studies. The politics are mainly what's controlling Washington and the relocation of Love Canal residents.
What if there is no federal aid coming?
Well, then the entity will take over and purchase the home. So regardless, we have a backup for the purchase. It's not like there's nothing there. There's something on the side if the federal government does fall through.
But what do we do then about Niagara County? Because they decided again the other night that they wouldn't join the authority.
That's true, but they can still form the authority with the city and the town of Wheatfield alone, without the county.
Why do you feel the federal government took so long to make this declaration, this emergency declaration? Do you feel it was a political decision because they were afraid it might be precedent setting and they might have to move many, many other people from around the country at various dump sites?
Definitely a political decision. That's one reason, and the reason they decided it now, I think, is more because it's the presidential election this year, and President Carter needs New York State votes. And one way to do it is please New York State residents and the governor.
How's the relocation coming right now? Are people happy with it? The people we talked to yesterday, not many of them were very jubilant. I know you figured that it was a victory, but many of them told us they were very disappointed because it was temporary and not permanent.
Yes, that's true, and because many of them had to give up their had to buy the hotel room themselves tonight, mm-hmm. and they didn't have the money to do so. And because it was temporary, and they've seen temporary time and time again, and they're tired of moving on a short term and moving back to the contaminated houses, they want to move somewhere for once, a clean environment, and stay put and raise their family somewhat normally for a change.
Are we going to see trouble if they move into another location and then they're told that they have to move back?
You are definitely going to see trouble, yes. The residents are not going to move back. They're fearful for their lives.
What do you think may happen?
Anything's possible, Marie. Anything.
All right, Mrs. Gibbs, thank you very much for joining us. If there's a hero or a heroine to come out of this, you're certainly it. Marie and I will be back with closing comments when we return with Love Canal, Neighborhood in Fear.
Why don't we discuss it over a beer?
You gotta have heart. You gotta have heart.
To light.
Your saving place makes saving nice with quality at a Kmart price.
Come and get it. Kmart Kettle Grill, the Weber. Weber's exclusive design mix for controlled cooking. And the porcelainized steel body keeps the varmints away. Only $39.97 for the big one, $29.97 for the smaller job. Doggone it. They're going fast. Get one by Saturday at Kmart.
Kmart is the same.
quench. Goes down easy. Cold, wet, never too sweet. Always refreshing. Quench flavor crystals in five great flavors. Quench beats thirst.
Amen.
Bells and Borden's get together, be assured that every delicious product is as fresh as all outdoors. Imagine fresh dairy goodness for warm weather dining. Bells and Borden's cottage cheese for salads and for fun. Bells and Borden's yogurt for lunches and desserts. Bells and Borden's sour cream for fancy dips. And Bells and Borden's ice cream for unbeatable summer treats. When you buy Borden's at Bells, you'll love the freshness that Borden's brings.
Bells makes your life easier.
From a quiet, unassuming residential neighborhood to a chemical ghost town, normal, everyday people over the last 2 years have come out fighting when their lives and the lives of their loved ones were endangered by a silent, unseen chemical threat.
The fight for the Love Canal homeowners isn't over yet. The federally ordered relocation is only temporary. The families want to move someplace permanently where they can live without fear of chemical poisoning.
Is can you go back and live in your parents' house? The answer is yes. The answer is yes, you can go back and live in your parents' house. The second question that you asked me was, what are the chances that you'll grow up to be a normal man? The answer to that question is that you have as much likelihood as growing up to be a normal man as someone living on 110th Street or 120th Street.